A former Super Bowl star is in the middle of a controversial battle over same-sex marriage in New York. The state Senate could vote today on that bill, while former New York Giants star David Tyree shocked some fans with this.
If they pass this gay marriage bill, I guess you could say my peace is in God's sovereignty. But what I know will happen if this does come forth is this will be the beginning of our country sliding toward, it's a strong word, but anarchy.
David Tyree on the phone with me now. David Tyree, it is a strong word. And tell me what you mean by anarchy.
Oh, definitely. I have no problem. You know, my definition, when I'm using anarchy, is in the sense of morality. And,
All right, we lost David Tyree there. We're going to try and get him back on the phone. Do we have him? Okay.
I'm back. How are you doing?
Are you still there, David?
I'm back. Sorry
about
that.
Okay, gotcha. I was asking you, lead to anarchy, same-sex marriage leading to anarchy. What exactly do you mean by that?
Yeah, I'm saying that in the sense of, basically morality. If there's no basis of, a moral fiber in a community, and we continue to slip away from that, I believe that will essentially lead to lawlessness. Now, does that mean that, there will be riots running around? I don't think that's not necessarily what I'm referring to.
What anarchy means. I mean, it's social and political disorder due to the absence of a government or control by the government.
I think if we look up the word anarchy, there's a few different definitions, but I don't want to really focus on that. I'm focusing on the I speak heavily in favor of marriage. I speak heavily in favor of one man and one woman. As far as a nuclear family, that's the ideal. That was the way a family was intended to be shaped and molded, and marriage is the backbone of society. I don't think anyone would disagree with that.
Where is the evidence, though, that gay marriage has any negative impact on other marriages or the sanctity of marriage or culture or children? Where is your evidence?
Where's the evidence? I can't necessarily get into statistics. That's not my voice. But I do know that marriage necessarily didn't start with our country. I said this in the video as well. I'm not interested in a theocracy. But if marriage was long existed before our country, I don't think that we are messing with something that God has actually ordained, set in order. And, if we've adopted into our government, then we should adopt it in the sense of, just like you adopt a child, you don't adopt a child and change their name. So to redefine marriage changes everything. It changes everything, how we educate our children. And I really believe that they should have the choice to make their lifestyle choices. But marriage is something that is holy. It's something that is sacred. And I believe it's something that should not be tainted with.
So let me ask you a couple questions. First of all, I'm thinking of a segment, David, that I did months back, and it was about this study that came out of the Williams Institute at UCLA, School of Law. And I had to go back and review my facts. It was 23 years that they did this study, and what it proved was that kids raised by lesbian parents had actually gained more respect for diversity, more respect for differences. And I'm just curious, as an African-American male, can you appreciate that?
Well, I can certainly appreciate it. I think those are, qualities to be applauded. I still don't necessarily think that has any, reflection on my views, my beliefs, and what I believe to be true as far as what marriage is. That's irrelevant as far as what the picture. What is a marriage? A marriage is between a man and a woman. That has always been the backbone of, our society and culture. And moving forward, I'll do everything in my power, my voice, to preserve that and protect that. I think it's worth fighting for.
But the research, David, also shows that two men and two men, or two women and two men also have very strong marriages and raise kids very well in addition to that. And I'm just curious, you talk about your dad not being in your home while you were growing up, and that had a big impact on you. What if you were raised by two women that loved each other and loved you, or two men that loved you and raised you in a very committed relationship? Are you saying that that's worse than a single parent home?
No, I've never said anything. I never said anything of the sort. But what it is, it's unnatural. I don't think that's necessarily a healthy model.
Explain unnatural to me. David, explain unnatural. Explain unnatural to me.
Well, if you look at what, a man and a woman, a marriage, what was the original intent of a marriage is to procreate, is to spawn off family and to continue to, to be the reflection of God in that sense of creation and multiplication and being fruitful. So
you're going into your religious perspective. You're going to your religious perspective. But what you've come out.
That's just if that is the makeup of every home, if this is, then can we procreate as a country?
It's not the makeup of every home, though. There are many same-sex marriages and relationships that have a very happy home and are raising very successful children.
That doesn't mean that it's natural.
I still am trying to understand what you mean by it not being natural.
I don't understand what's difficult. A man and a woman actually, come together to procreate. A man and a man will never procreate. So, can they actually have values and sense of raising children? Most certainly.
What about infertile couples? Infertile couples have children all the time. Is that unnatural?
How is that? That actually has no bearing. That makes no sense. A man and a woman are still coming together to raise a child, which actually paints a nuclear family.
There are women and women come together and raise a family as well, and a man and a man come together and raise a family as well.
I understand your views.
I'm not expressing my views. I'm just stating a fact.
Well, I understand your adamancy, for equality, and I understand. I even actually understand their battle. But, to redefine marriage, it did not start with our country. It has always been throughout ages between a man and a woman, and that is the central theme. I believe that a man and a woman, raising a child has the best chances. And I believe that there are studies that would also say that, has the best chances for that child to do well in his upbringing and in this, as they mature as a person to be, fruitful in our society. So I just,
David, real quickly,
using my beliefs.
What? Just finally, a number of your fellow athletes have come forward disagreeing with you. Even former teammates. I mean, I looked through the list: Charles Barkley, Steve Nash, Michael Strahan, Sean Avery. All of them have spoken out for marriage equality, and they're in support of gay and lesbian friends and neighbors and fans. What's your response to that?
Oh man, I love them. They're entitled to their opinion, and that's fine. But I believe that if you remove marriage or if you redefine marriage, you are tinkering with a moral fabric in our society that opens up the gateway for everyone to basically what's to stop polygamy from coming in for a polygamist to say, well, I believe I should have my five wives. It opens up the door to a whole other sense of what I believe to be lawlessness. And so, yes, was a very strong word, but essentially that's what, it leads to. It's not about having a riot or, but I do believe that is social disorder when we are actually redefining the family.